I call the deputy, Catherine Murphy.
Tánaiste, I want to raise with you today the circumstances surrounding the Y case and the subsequent draft report. The last time I addressed this issue with you was on the day the Dáil went into recess. And that was the week the UN commented strongly and criticised Ireland in relation to its abortion regime, particularly in cases of rape, incest, where there's a fetal abnormality and where the woman's health is at risk. Since then, we've had the tragic Y case and the publication of draft guidelines, which appear to be even more restrictive than the limited legislation. In fact, the guidelines, Miss Y would be even less likely to have received the termination that she requested. One consultant psychiatrist, Veronica O'Keen, in the Business Post, says that in the opening statement of the draft guidelines, it serves to reinforce the complete prohibition on abortion and not, as one might expect, to make abortion legal when a woman's life is at risk. Over the summer, we read the barbaric details of the Y case, the case of a very young woman arriving in a foreign country, having been raped, and was told that it was not within our financial remit to have a termination. And ultimately, after attempting suicide, she was forced to deliver the baby through an unwanted cesarean section. We've had the X case, we've had the tragic Savita Hanifer case. We're running out of letters in the alphabet, but behind each one of them, there's a real woman who happens to be a wife, a sister, a mother, a daughter. This Saturday, people will take to the streets in a march for choice. Each time the numbers grow, and how many times will it take before the government listens and acts?
Question, please. Thank you.
The reality of it is that the young woman involved, if we're looking at the report, was not even consulted. Everyone else seems to have been consulted, but not the young woman.
Thank you.
The government can ignore the calls for the repeal of the Eighth Amendment. And the last time I asked you about this, you said people were consulted in 1983. You had to be born in 1960, before 1966, to have been consulted. I'm asking you, Tánaiste, about the guidelines. Did you see the guidelines? Did you agree to the guidelines? Are you aware the guidelines are more restrictive than the legislation?
Thank you.
And will you acknowledge the public calls and the changing public opinion in relation to repealing the Eighth Amendment?
Thank you.
Thank you. In relation to the references that you made, Deputy, to the case of Miss Y, I think we're all aware that this is a very sad case of a young woman who arrived in Ireland seeking protection as an asylum seeker, and that subsequently her baby was delivered. And what I'm concerned about in discussing this is that her confidentiality and her vulnerability should be respected, but also that of the baby. There is a young woman, a young mother, and a young baby involved in this, and I think at the outset we need to say that we want to see the best outcomes for both of them. She has since been granted legal status in Ireland, refugee status in Ireland, and I also understand that she is currently in some contact through her legal representatives with the team which are inquiring into the circumstances of what happened. The information which was published in the media in recent times is not a report. I understand it arises, the information which has come into the public domain, from work being carried out in the context of the report which is being prepared. And I understand that Ms. Y, through her legal advisers, which is appropriate, is in some contact with the people carrying out the inquiry. But that really is a matter for her and for her legal advisers. advisers, and I think it's important that we don't intrude on her privacy or that of the baby in relation to the ongoing inquiry, which I hope will be concluded as quickly as possible, and we will then get the full facts on the case. But what appears to have happened in terms of the information which was published to date and which was broadcast this week is that there seems to be, as we know from when this case first came into the public domain, missing information in relation to what actually happened to her at various stages. So this is not a report, nothing has been published, and I think it would be appropriate to wait until the full facts as can be established into this particular case are published by the HSE inquiry team. And that's been a commitment which was given in late August by the chief executive of the HSE. In relation to the guidelines, those guidelines were published last week by the Minister for Health and by the HSE, and clearly doctors involved in the care of women, both during pregnancy, in terms at birth and after pregnancy, I expect in the context of the debate that they will discuss and consider those guidelines.
Thank you.
In relation to your question on the Eighth Amendment, I believe I answered this before. The Labour Party, way back in 1983, did not support the introduction of the Eighth Amendment into the Irish Constitution. What I said to you before was that the people of Ireland voted for the amendment of the Constitution in their wisdom. And quite a lot of parties in this House supported that amendment. The Labour Party did not. I myself campaigned at that time against it. And they're the facts of the situation. I agree with you that public opinion in this matter has changed. But remember that we have about 70,000 babies born in Ireland every year. And I think one of the things is that we want those babies to be wanted babies, and we want them to be born in the best possible circumstances.
Thank you. Deputy Murphy.
Taoiseach, there was a report published, it was a draft report published in the newspapers this week, and what it talked about was the report was highly critical of how disjointed the process was and how impossible it is to coordinate the response. And that, I've got to say, is really setting alarm bells ringing in terms of the protection of women in situations where their lives are at risk. Now, can I say about the Labour Party and 1983, and I want to acknowledge the role the Labour Party played at that time. It was brave, it was against public opinion, it took courage, but you are letting those people who went out in 1983 down. If you took that position then, when you're not prepared to take a position now, when public opinion is on your side, and you're in a position to do something about it, that, I've got to say, must be hugely disappointing to Labour Party people. You didn't adequately answer the question in relation to the guidelines. Are you satisfied with them? They are less. They roll back on the legislation, which is restrictive legislation. Did you agree with them?
Thank you.
And are you happy with that restrictive legislation? Is even more restrictive in relation to the guidelines. What role did you play in agreeing them?
Well, I think you're actually rushing to judgment, Deputy, if I may say so. I can understand why, given your own particular stance, and you have always been upfront about these issues, and I respect that. But I think that you're actually rushing to judgment, and I want to make this distinction. We have to find the actual facts of the case. And in relation to the document that was published earlier, it actually says on each page that this is a draft document and can only be considered as such. This document can be expected to contain factual clinical inaccuracies and or information that may require additional clarification. So I want to put it to you that it's not a report, it's not even a draft report, it's workings and draft documentation in relation to a report which is going to be very important to establish the facts of what happened. You're asking me to anticipate the outcome of the report, and I can't do that because I don't know the facts, and I want to be very clear about that. In relation to the guidelines, let me say this, that it's the legislation which was passed by the Dáil here, in my view, so far has actually operated in a way to protect, and this is what it's designed to do, to protect both the life of the mother and the life of the baby during pregnancy. And the circumstances of this particular case is that, from what we know from the public domain, the circumstances came to the panel and to the operation of the Protection of Life and Pregnancy Bill very late in the pregnancy. Now, if you're suggesting that at 24 weeks somebody should be given an abortion, I just want to make clear that that's not a position. That's not a position that I agree. That's not a position that I support. I want to make that clear. But what we don't know, and what we need to wait on the report to get the best possible information, is what actually happened to the young woman between the period when the pregnancy was identified and the period when she came before the panel in the context of the operation of the pregnancy, of the Protection of Life and Pregnancy Act. And we don't know as yet, Deputy, the answers to that, and therefore I think you're jumping to conclusions before we get the facts.
Thank you. That completes leaders' questions for today.